It needs teachers. And it needs hungry students. Do you know what? It's not brick and mortar. Look, are we into brick and mortar today? We are into wall-less technology. So where is the brick and mortar gone? Where are those heavy walls and halls and convention halls of MITs and Harvards today? Where? Last 2 years, we haven't had that. Last year, 2 years, what have you had? You've had online learning. You've had teachers. You've done online study by yourself. And you've been students yourself. So tell me, where is the building? Where is the infrastructure? So India needs teachers and India needs students. And India needs hungry students, curious students, self-driven students, self-learning students, self-researching students. Today's times are very different. Today, the entire university is in Google. A lot of learning is on YouTube. You can do a lot of self-learning. There is no limit today. So India needs, yes, India needs policies. India needs huge amount of financial investments. India needs money into research. India needs laboratories, no doubt about it. India needs a lot of stipends and scholarships for it, agreed. India needs a lot of paid internships and apprenticeships. Again, it needs money. So India needs money for these kinds of investments. But if you're looking for the size of your school and college, then your tree is also today a class. A tree today in the Mahabharata and the Ramayana times, you had universities? No, you had the trees. You had the forests and you had total dedication towards your guru. You had the guru shishya parampara. So I think if Indian education needs, it needs both. It needs a lot of funding, a lot of financial investments, not only brick and mortar, but it needs teachers who are also students. And it also needs students who are also teachers for themselves. This is what India needs.